I'm bussin'. Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome back to the Gamers Cage. Today, and only today, we are here to talk a bit more about Sonic Frontiers. That's it. We're approaching the end of the year. This is probably the last video of at least this year, you know, for the next 4 days, about Sonic Frontiers, and someone just followed me. But today, I figured we would talk about something different, and that is what you guys wanted to see most in Sonic Frontiers. I took to Twitter.com, you know, the website full of psychos like you, and asked a bunch of people what they wanted to see in the game. I got over like 300 responses. So what I did, right, it was instead of obviously us going through every response, because that would be stupid, I sort of gathered the most common points I saw, and I figured I would talk about those, you know what I mean? So let's sit down. So the first thing, when it comes to this game, let's go ahead and let's have this trailer for this game playing while we talk about this shit. First thing people wanted, this is the most common repeated thing here, movement. People want the movement in Sonic Frontiers to be awesome. Obviously, this is just common sense that people want the movement to be good, but I think what a lot of people were saying was they want it to feel good. They wanted to, you know, bring back a bit of the parkour systems from Lost World. You know, they want Sonic, you know, if he is going to be in an open world environment where we're going to be really just constantly running and going around this world, they want it to feel good and fluid. And I agree with the sentiment. I think to me, the most important thing I want from this game is movement. You know, I want to feel like I'm spin dashing through areas. You know, I could do a trick in the air. You know, I could run on this wall. You know, I want it to feel liberating and fun. You know, and I think if the movement in this game is awesome, I feel like that can carry so much of this game, because a big part of it is just that now, like, you could open that game whenever you finish it or whatever and just run through that world. You know, the way I said it always was, I want the game to feel like I'm playing the Sonic CD intro. You know, the one where he's running through the field and going through the flips and all that. That's what I want this game to feel like. And I think they really can succeed at that if they really just work on the movement. I feel like that should be the number one priority on their list. And that's sort of the number one thing people want to see from the game. And I agree with them. Now, the second most requested thing I saw people mention was playable characters. And this one's a weird one, right? Because it's weird, right? With Sonic games, there's been a history, obviously, of multiple playable characters. You know, people like playing as the cast, you know, as their favorite characters. And obviously, in the original adventure games, that was such a big part of those games. I do think that this game might only be Sonic. Now, obviously, we only have one trailer and just one character shot. Now, here's the thing. They could surprise us. There's a lot we don't know about this game. But I feel something in me tells me this is just a game about Sonic. And the reason I think that is because maybe they really want to emphasize the amount of polish and care they put into one character as opposed to multiple playable characters. Now, I could see this game getting expansions, right? I could see this game getting, like, if it's successful enough that it actually gets, like, hey, here's a legit Shadow the Hedgehog expansion. Hey, here's a legit Silver or Blaze or something. I could definitely see this game getting expansions, but I do think at launch, it is going to be purely Sonic. But people were also saying they just want the other characters to matter. And I definitely agree with that, right? I don't want the cast to just be like, oh, hey, Sonic, good to see you here. Like, I want them, you know, to have a reason to be there. You know, obviously, we all know about, you know, the Ghost Amy, right? And what does the Ghost Amy mean? Like, why is she Ghost Amy? I assume she's trapped in another dimension. She is guiding you, right? Which emphasizes to me that, like, she knows some shit about this world or whatever. So that alone right there has me excited about the prospect of what they're doing with Amy and whatever other characters, because we know there's going to be other characters coming back. We know Eggman's going to be there. He confirmed that. We know Tails, I think, is going to be there. There's a lot we don't know about the game, but in terms of characters, like I said, I agree with y'all. I want the ones that show up to actually matter. You know, I want Knuckles to not just be like, basically the characters and writing and all that stuff should feel a little bit more how it used to be, where obviously it is silly and they have their funny moments, but there is room for cool, like, just Sonic X-ify it. To me, Sonic X and, you know, like, again, Sonic Adventure was a perfect blend of, like, the silly, funny moments mixed with, like, a bit of a serious story, instead of the more modern games where it is like, oh, everything's just like a Saturday morning cartoon, which I don't mind. Again, I like Sonic for its antiques and stuff, but I want something a little more a little more out there for the character and characters. But yeah, in terms of playable ones, I really do think it's going to be Sonic for now. Next one people were mentioning a lot of was a larger emphasis on Super Sonic, right? For obviously, Super Sonic, a big part of Sonic games, but very lowered in terms of how much it matters in the recent game. It didn't really matter in Lost World. It didn't really matter in, what's it called? In Sonic Forces, very clearly, because it was DLC. It didn't even matter in Sonic Colors, really. I mean, like, there is, like, the you can unlock Super Sonic, but the final boss you're not fighting in Super Sonic. You have, like, the, you do, like, the big spin with the wisps and stuff. But, yeah, no, I think I understand what people mean, is they want the return to sort of an emphasis on, you know, getting the seven cast Emeralds, feeling the satisfying thing. And you know, a lot of the leaks for the game were saying that, like, you go to those cyberspace portals that play like boost levels and you get a Chaos Emerald, and maybe you get, like, maybe it is like the old school Sonic games where, like, as soon as you get the seven Chaos Emeralds, you could turn to Super Sonic whenever. So maybe, like, this game, like, early on, you can turn to Super Sonic and, you know, using the environments to beat certain enemies and things, and maybe there is a better form at the end, you know. Again, I don't want to get my hopes up, but wouldn't it be dope as fuck if they brought back Hypersonic somehow? Like, that, dude, Hypersonic in modern day would be the sickest thing ever. Again, don't think they're going to do it, but if they did, oh my god, if they did, that would be cool. But yeah, I understand what people mean. I think they want, like, they want that sort of grand scale finale with Super Sonic, you know, like we had in Unleash, like we had in the adventure games, and even like in the storybook games, you know, with like the armored gold Sonic and stuff. I understand what people mean. Yeah, a larger emphasis on Super Sonic is something I would definitely like to see. And I, again, I do want it, because what's cool about an open world is it could make using Super Sonic more fun for certain scenarios. Because a lot of times when you unlock Super Sonic game, you're sort of like, it's either sort of a hindrance to the level, right, or it's cool to try out once. So if there is a bit more of a reason to mess with Super Sonic, I'm down for that. Next one, obviously a big one people are mentioning, Crush 40. People really, really want the main theme of the game to be a Crush 40 track, and in general, they want the soundtrack to be banging. Now, even me, I haven't even talked about the soundtrack much. I agree with you, man. The soundtrack for this game, I do not. The last thing I want for this game is to do the environmental sounds when you're running through the environment. Please do not do that. Sonic is all about the music. I mean, it's not all about it, but it's a massive part of this franchise. So when I'm running around that world, don't do the atmosphere like birds chirping, squirrels munching, you know, penises flying, making dick sounds and stuff. Don't do that, all right? That's not actually a thing. But, like, just make it so that, like, you know, there's actual cool music playing throughout. I assume if these cyberspace levels are real, that those are gonna be where the banging tracks shine, or the boss fights and stuff like that. So, really, I agree with y'all. But Crush 40 doing the main theme, please, bro. They came back for Green Light Ride for Team Sonic Racing. So I think Sega and Sonic Team understand that Crush 40 is a big part of the Sonic DNA. Even they came back for the Symphony. People, they understand this. So please do not fumble. And I agree, bring Crush 40 in for the main OSC. Now, well, for the main checklist. Then next one, a big one people are mentioning, combat, right? People don't want it to just be that, you know, you headbutt the enemy with the spin dashes, especially in an open world, right? Because, like, what is it going to be like when you enter a combat scenario? And a lot of people are saying, you know, because they want this game to have a bit more, you know, combat where you have to think a little bit. Now, here's the thing, right? It is a Sonic game, so I don't think the combat, no matter what, is going to be crazy. You know, I feel like Sonic Boom would be the closest thing to an actual combat that you have in the games. And I don't mind that. Like, Sonic Boom isn't bad because it has combat. Sonic Boom, the game, has a million other problems. But the idea, you know, of Sonic having punches and kicks like in Smash, and maybe he has, like, maybe certain enemies only will die if you spin dash into them with a certain move or use a certain attack on them, that would be cool. I feel like some sort of light challenge with the combat would be nice. Because I feel like, I don't know, I feel like in an open world, if you just do the thing where you run to a camp and you, like, do the thing where you pop into five enemies, sure, it'll be satisfying, but how long will it be satisfying for? You know, it makes sense in what's called, in the linear boost levels, because usually attacking the enemies is a way for you to progress through the level. You know, you're jumping over them through platforms. You're using them to activate a button or something. But here, if there's going to be multiple enemies and stuff, I feel like they could do something fun. Again, I do think at its core, it's going to be button mashy, the combat. But if there are, like, some cool moves you can do in there, we'll see about that. Because, again, if you remember the first teaser for the game where he does that, like, circle around the forest, that seems to be, like, it's going to be, like, one of the main hooks of the game or whatever in general, this like this whole cyber flow he's got going on here, because like he does this multiple times. I feel like that's going to be a big part of the game, and I really wonder how it's going to play into the world. But I agree with you all, combat seems to be something that they should definitely work on, and we'll see. One of the last points we got here is the Chao Garden, right? A lot of people want the Chao Garden. An open world game feels like a perfect time to bring that. You know, you find like a little farm or something, and that's where they go. I've been saying this, what if the Korok seeds of this game were Chao's? Like, just Chao's, you find the environment that you bring back. I really agree with you, and I know one of the directors of the Chao Garden is working on the game from back then. So this is, I feel like this is your best shot at getting the Chao Garden. I feel like if it's not in this game, RIP to the Chao Garden, bro. But I agree with y'all. Listen, man, the Chao Garden was always a very fun side game that people love. Some people really love it more than Adventure 2, to be honest. There's some people that are crazy about the Chao Garden. So I really do think it would be easy money for them. They could even do DLC for Chao Garden stuff. You know, if they wanna have microtransactions and stuff in the future, you know, give it for this game for the Chao Garden. You know, and I think Chao Garden would be hella dope. Like I said, of all games to have it, open world would make sense. And yeah, so that's really it for Chao Garden. But yeah, those are the most common points you all gave me. And obviously, the number one good point being a good game. Yeah, I know. I'm with you all. I hope it's a dope game. We all want that. But yeah, no, those are the sort of most common points that I saw whenever people were talking about stuff. Again, there are a lot of story, a lot of combat, a lot of movement, a lot of free flow, good writing, all the stuff you expect. But yeah, I figured I would grab, like, you know, the most popular requests from people and sort of have them in there. But man, yeah, I can't wait for this game. Next year is going to be crazy. And also, before we go, one more thing is that there was a database leak for PlayStation, and it has the game listed for November 15th. Now, this isn't too shocking. Like, I think this game is slated for a holiday next year. So I feel like, yeah, November 15th makes sense. It's right before Black Friday. It gives them the entire year to work on the game. And yeah, no, I think that date makes sense if it's real or if it isn't. And I hope it is, man, because I can't wait till we see this. I wonder when the next time we're even going to see this game is. I feel like, I'm guessing like March, you know, where they usually have SXSW. I feel like that's the next time we're going to see like actual gameplay of the game. But yeah, so let me know what you guys think. For the people that aren't on Twitter or didn't get to mention, what do you want to see most from this game? Do you care most about the combat? Do you care most about movement, story, anything? Let me know what you think, and I'll see you all soon. I'll probably have a video or two more before the end of the year. And I love you. Bye, motherfuckers. And of course, like the video, subscribe, blah, 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 blah.